So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. So let's begin with the session, guys. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed, and here you can ask any doubt also. So let's talk about the very first question, which says Ministry of Education, which is headed by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan, has conducted National Achievement Survey 2021. The question is, which of the following organizations is the nodal body for the survey? All right, so this very new survey, National Achievement Survey 2021, has been conducted by Ministry of Education. Do you remember, headed by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan? Okay, so this survey was conducted in all the 36 states and UTs. जितने भी हमारे स्टेट्स और यूटीज हैं सबके अंदर ये वाला जो सर्वे था, दिस वॉज कंडक्टेड एंड दिस सर्वे रिमेंबर वॉज कंडक्टेड टू कलेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट वॉट स्टूडेंट्स नो अंडरस्टैंड एंड कैन डू विद देयर नॉलेज. स्टूडेंट्स के पास जो नॉलेज है वो उसको कितना समझते हैं और वो उसको किस तरीके से कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं यूजफुल चीज़ों में, ये सारी चीज़ों की इन्फॉर्मेशन लेने के लिए दिस सर्वे वॉज कंडक्टेड इन ऑल द 36 स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन. And you remember, it has been conducted under the National New Education Policy of 2020. All right. Now talking more about this survey. So remember, there are three phases of the survey. Number one, instrument development. Number two, sampling design. And number three, actual administration of the test. पहले सबसे पहले क्या किया इन्होंने? Instrument develop किया, then sampling designing, and then finally actual administration of the test. And this is very important thing to remember here, that actual administration of test was conducted by CBSE. Actual administration of test was conducted by CBSE, and CBSE chairperson is Mr. Manoj Ahuja. Manoj Ahuja is the chairperson of CBSE. But also at the same time, do remember that the nodal agency for conducting this survey was NCERT. NCERT was the nodal agency to conduct the survey, while the actual administration of the test was conducted by CBSE. All right. And of course, the results of this NAS, National Achievement Survey 2021, will be released at the district level, at the state or UT level, and at the national level. Okay. So, अभी इसमें इतना ही है. Of course, जब इसके results आ जाएंगे, then we will discuss more about this survey. All right. So, this was about this news, guys. And now let's come back to the question. Here, the question is regarding the nodal body for the survey. So, that's NCERT. And please do not confuse between NCERT and CBSE. CBSE conducted the actual administration of the test, while NCERT is the nodal agency. Okay, option B, NCERT is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 2. How many households will get tap water connections in Uttar Pradesh as per the target set by the state government under Jal Jeevan Mission in financial year 2021-22? This question is regarding this financial year. Okay, so ye main change kar dunga, don't worry, in the PDF. In financial year 21-22, what is the target which has been set by the government of UP to provide tap water connection in the rural areas under Jal Jeevan Mission? And of course, I hope you all know this, Jal Jeevan Mission is also known as Har Ghar Jal Mission, under which tap water will be provided to the rural areas by 2024. Okay. So this news is regarding the Jal Jeevan Mission in Uttar Pradesh. So the news is that 735 drinking water supply schemes worth rupees 1,880 crores have been sanctioned by State Level Scheme Sanctioning Committee of Uttar Pradesh. State Level Scheme Sanctioning Committee of Uttar Pradesh ne Uttar Pradesh mein 735 drinking water supply scheme worth rupees 1,882 crores approve kar diya hai. And remember, this State Level Sanctioning Committee is formed under the provisions of Jal Jeevan Mission. There is a provision under Jal Jeevan Mission that there would be a state level scheme sanctioning committee which has the responsibility of sanctioning the schemes. All right. Now this has been done, of course, to provide tap water connections in the rural areas. Now talking more about this news, so these schemes, these 735 scheme will cover a population of 39 lakh in 1,262 villages of 33 districts of Uttar Pradesh. Kitne districts? 33 districts Uttar Pradesh mein, 1,262 villages mein 39 lakh ko ye population cover karega. All right. Now in 2021-22, in this financial year, the state government has set the target that they will provide tap water connections to the 78 lakh people 78 लाख पॉपुलेशन ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश, ठीक है, तो 78 लाख हाउस होल्ड को ये ड्रिंकिंग वाटर टैप कनेक्शन दिया जाएगा इन दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर, और ऐसा टारगेट है उत्तर प्रदेश का। एंड अंडर जल जीवन मिशन डू रिमेंबर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति हैज ऑलरेडी गिवन ₹2,400 करोड़ ग्रांट इन एड टू उत्तर प्रदेश फॉर दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर, एंड टोटल ग्रांट्स फॉर उत्तर प्रदेश फॉर कंप्लीटिंग फॉर अचीविंग द 100% टैप वाटर कनेक्शन इन उत्तर प्रदेश इज हाउ मच, इट इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 23,500 करोड़। ये नंबर याद हो जाता है तो वेल एंड गुड, अदरवाइज देर इज नो नीड बिकॉज दिस नंबर इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली। ऑफकोर्स जब आगे चीजें बढ़ेंगी, जब ये स्कीम प्रोग्रेस करेगी, तो ऑफकोर्स मोर फंडिंग विल बी रिक्वायर्स एंड दिस अमाउंट विल डेफिनेटली इंक्रीज। तो अगर ये याद हो जाता है तो ठीक है, अदरवाइज देर इज नो प्रॉब्लम। Alright, so therefore guys, the correct answer will be what? 78 lakh, because this question is regarding this financial year's target of Uttar Pradesh under Jal Jeevan Mission, 78 lakh logo ko isme tap water connection diya jayega. And talking more about Uttar Pradesh, of course you all know Yogi Adityanath is the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh. Recently the great Kangana Ranaut has been nominated as the brand ambassador of One District One Product scheme of Uttar Pradesh. Very recently from Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh, Prime Minister has launched Prime Minister's Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Scheme worth ₹64,180 crores. Remember, this scheme was announced in the Union Budget 2021-22. And of course, this year's Def Expo was held, Def Expo 2021 was held in Lucknow, capital of Uttar Pradesh. And the next Def Expo will be held in Gandhinagar, Gujarat. And talking more about Uttar Pradesh, so Uttar Pradesh government has recently launched Matrabhumi Yojana, इन्होंने recently launch किया था। Faizabad railway station in Uttar Pradesh is now named as Ayodhya Cantonment railway station, उसका नया नाम है। And in Uttar Pradesh you will find Pilibhit Tiger Reserve, you will find Dudhwa National Park, you will find Kishanpur Wildlife Sanctuary, you will find Katarniya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary, and you will also find Chandra Prabha Wildlife Sanctuary. Alright, Chandra Prabha Wildlife Sanctuary bhi wahi pe milta hai. So these are some basic news about basic GK about Uttar Pradesh. Alright, so let's move ahead to question number 3. Which private company will run the first operationalized private sector defense manufacturing facility in UP defense industrial corridor? So as you all know, there are two defense industrial corridor which is being constructed in the country, one in UP and another is in Tamil Nadu, inaugurated by Defense Minister Rajnath Singh. Kaun si private company hai jo ki run karegi the very first operationalized private sector defense manufacturing facility in UP defense industrial corridor? See, इस वाली न्यूज में देर आर सो मेनी टेक्निकल थिंग्स, बट यू डोंट हैव टू गो इन टू द टेक्निकलिटीज ऑफ दिस न्यूज कि वो क्या करेंगी, कैसे करेंगी और क्या क्या तरीके होंगे, दैट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड। यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ द प्राइवेट कंपनी विच विल रन दिस ऑपरेशनलाइज्ड प्राइवेट सेक्टर डिफेंस मैन्युफैक्चरिंग फैसिलिटी इन यूपी डिफेंस इंडस्ट्रियल कॉरिडोर, एंड द नेम ऑफ द कंपनी इज एरोलॉय टेक्नोलॉजी विच इज अ होली ओन सब्सिडरी ऑफ पीटीसी इंडस्ट्री। Alright, PTC industry ka ye wholly owned subsidiary and the name of the company is Aeroloy Technologies. Now what will this private sector defense manufacturing facility will do? It will manufacture parts of aircraft engines, helicopter engines, drones, UAVs, theek hai, submarines, in sab ke ye jo parts hai ye company banayegi. So therefore guys, the correct answer will be what? The correct answer will be Aeroloy Technology. And Rajnath Singh's Lok Sabha constituency is Lucknow, which is of course the capital of Uttar Pradesh. And for welfare of SC STs and other backward classes, unke liye committee banayi gayi hai, which is headed by Mr. Rajnath Singh. Moving ahead, question number 4. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge? Okay. So why we are discussing about Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge? It was the launch in the year 2020. Then why we are discussing it right now? Because very recently, Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri, has launched a week-long awareness campaign for Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge, starting from 14th November to 20th November. Okay, Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge SSC. I will call it SSC from now because bar bar repeat ho raha hai. SSC was launched In the year 2020, on the occasion of World Toilet Day, that was on 19th November 2020. And currently, there are 246 cities which are participating in the challenge. All right. Now, talking more about this SSC, so there are various initiatives which are undergoing under this Safai Mitra Suraksha Challenge. Number one is Loan Melas, which are being organized by National Safai Karamchari Finance and Development Corporation in support of Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. And in these loan melas, the Safai Mitras are availing the loans under Swachhata Udyami Yojana. Under Swachhata Udyami Yojana for procurement of sewer or septic tank cleaning equipments. Okay? And 26 loan melas have been conducted till now, and total 6.73 crore loan have been disbursed to 74 Safai Mitras. Alright. Moving ahead to other initiatives. Skill development trainings of Safai Mitras are being conducted through again National Safai Karamchari Finance and Development Corporation. And do remember, this NSKFDC works under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. ठीक है, ये Social Justice and Empowerment के अंदर काम करता है. And this skill development training is being conducted in 115 cities through NSKFDC. All right. And this training module is of course based on the recognition of prior learning model. And till now, 9,200 Safai Mitras have completed their trainings. Another initiative is a call center and a helpline number for safe cleaning have been operationalized in 345 cities. And do remember, the helpline number 14420 is the helpline number. Ek exam tha, I'm forgetting the name of exam. Usme ek kisi ek particular initiative ka helpline number bhi pooch liya tha. So they are asking anything today. So, हमें मैक्सिमम टू मैक्सिमम चीजों को कवर करके चलना है. सो यू शुड रिमेंबर दिस हेल्पलाइन नंबर ऑल्सो. सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. हियर यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. द चैलेंज वॉज लॉन्च ऑन 19 नवंबर 2020. यस, एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. टोटल 246 सिटीज आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द चैलेंज. यस, दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट. हेल्पलाइन नंबर फॉर सेफ क्लीनिंग हैज बीन ऑपरेशनलाइज इन 345 सिटीज. करेक्ट. Loan melas have been organized to provide loans to Safai Mitras. This is also correct. And 6.73 crore loan have been sanctioned already to 74 Safai Mitras. The challenge is being implemented by Ministry of Jal Shakti. Is that so? No, it is not being implemented by Ministry of Jal Shakti. It is by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Okay. So the correct answer, guys, should be option E, because this is the incorrect statement here. Moving ahead to question number 5. To how many beneficiaries of Tripura first installment of Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen has been transferred by the Prime Minister? Tripura ke kitne beneficiaries ko Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen ki pehli installment di ja chuki hai? Of course, this scheme has the objective to provide houses to the rural people, because see, there are two components of Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. One is urban and one is Grameen. Agar aapko is scheme ke baare mein janna hai, to you can search for Government Schemes Anuj Jindal. There is a playlist. वहाँ पे सारी की सारी important schemes have been covered by me. All right. और ये वाली scheme भी वहाँ पे covered है. So here the correct answer, guys, is what? Option A. 1.7 lakh beneficiaries को प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना ग्रामीण के अंडर जो first installment है वो मिल गई है. And this installment was transferred by Prime Minister himself. Moving ahead to question number 6. Which ministry has launched Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav mobile app to enable all single point access to all the information related to the 75th anniversary celebration of India's independence? Very easy question, very direct question. और इस question का अंदाजा तो हम वैसे भी लगा सकते हैं through the options. और इस news में से अगर कोई question आया तो यही हो सकता है, इससे ज़्यादा नहीं होगा, because they will not definitely not ask the name of the mobile app, because वो काफ़ी लंबा है. This ministry, guys, is Ministry of Culture headed by Mr. G. Kishan Reddy. G. Kishan Reddy is the Minister of Culture, Minister of Tourism and Minister of Development of Northeastern Region, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Secunderabad. ठीक है, Secunderabad इनकी Lok Sabha constituency है. So that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you on Friday. Goodbye, take care and God bless.